On this episode of Hola LA. Making bad look so good. Emilio Rivera of Sons of Anarchy stops by.
They had actors playing bad guys, and I was a real bad guy.
Welcome to our show from the Sons of Anarchy, El Mayan. You are a badass Mayan.
I try to stay busy, yeah. So if they want a bad guy, I'll play him, you know?
Absolutely.
Thank you. First of all, thank you for having me on.
I'm glad to be here.
Thanks for being here.
And you're
awesome.
You're such a bad guy that you killed your onsen on the show?
Yeah, a guy played Kevin Alejandro, who plays Eastside.
He was in our show a couple of years ago.
Yeah.
Was he really?
Yes.
He didn't talk about that?
He didn't. We didn't give him enough time.
How did you end up with a blue-eyed son?
I was with a blue-eyed girl. You know?
Blue-eyed girl. Yeah, you know. That's fabulous.
So that was great. But how did you get started in acting? That's a wonderful, fantastic story.
You know, I got clean and sober. May 15th will be 23 years now. And what I did is I needed to do something. You know, I'm an addict, you know. So I got into the acting thing, the theater. Started doing that at theater. And that was my hook. I mean, that was my new high.
Yes.
And it just kind of, it worked out, man. You know, and at the time, they had actors playing bad guys, and I was a real bad guy playing.
That's interesting. As a bad guy, were your friends at the time in real life giving you slack? Like, what's that? What do you mean doing theater?
I was always like a bad guy in real life, so nobody really told me nothing.
Nobody touched him. That's just you playing, differently.
But in real life, it's just more easier being a nice guy, you know what I'm saying? But I was really a bad guy, man.
So that's your first role?
Was a show called Renegade with Lorenzo Lamas, TV show, you know, and it's really weird because 21 years later now I'm playing on a biker show, so it's really weird how to go full circle, you know.
Emilio, you've been working so much. What is your secret or key to success?
You know, I'm going to tell you what it is, you know, just be nice to everybody, man. You know, it's that goes a long way.
I tried that, but usually, I want a little more.
Do you go
that extra step?
I just go and be ready. Do your work, you know.
Be prepared.
And it's really a small circle, man. Because I look at it now, and it's all the people I've worked for. They all know each other, so they call you because they can count on you, you know.
And what I love about Sons of Anarchy, it might be the show with the most Latino representation, right? We have Benito Martinez.
I love it.
We've got Jimmy Smith, Danny Trejo,
with more male Latino representation.
We also had Wanda de Jesus.
Okay,
but they still need a Ramona from Pomona.
I don't know why she's not there. She should be on the back of my bike.
All these bikers need ladies, right? Rucas on the back of their motorcycles.
Talking about comedy, you both did comedy.
Well, that's why I was bringing it up because
we did comedy. You know, I was good about Deanna. You know, she, you know, even 18 years ago, I started doing comedy. And I used to do the show called Latino Nights. And I used to produce and write it.
Yep.
And she would come in. She used to come in and do the tour. And
I'd wear my flannel shirt and my big chola wig. And I'd do Ramona from Pomona.
So I would create a vato. I'm Chato, that crazy vato who was in love with her. You know what I'm saying?
Do you help people that were in your situation and are trying to get
why,
out of it?
That's why I'm still alive, man. You know, I go to prison, juvenile halls, and I speak. Because when they listen to me, they know I'm the real guy. You dig what I'm saying? Right. And I just spoke to 1,200 kids about a month ago in Fontana. And I started talking about a little bit about my gang life. And they started, there was a little group of vatos there. And they were like, yeah! And then I shut them up. I go, nah, man, don't applaud that. Right. That's the part of my life that I didn't like, you know?
Yes.
And the congressman that was there said, you know what, bro? It's like, if I would have said that, they would have booed me. But they just kept quiet. And it's respect,
exactly.
you know?
That's the importance of it coming from you. Because
they
glorify, you know, the roles that you do, which you played a lot of gangbangers and all. So they glorify that. But when they hear you say what you did, it's like, hey, that's not the
it's terrible
glory part.
You know, it's just like, you know, I heard a lot of my own people, like people that even that could have been my brothers, you know. We looked alike. Those times that, you know, like, wow, I did that, and he's like, he could have been my brother in real life. You dig what I'm saying?
But if you hadn't turned your life around, bottom line is you wouldn't be where you are today.
Not at all, no way.
Exactly.
I was a bad guy, man, you know. And plus I did a lot of drugs and so I couldn't remember lines back then. You know, first, there's a book called, you got to get this book. It's called Stop Acting, Start Living by Bernard Hiller. And he has a two-page article, I mean, a story about it.
Thank you so much for being here, Emilio. We look forward to seeing you again.